In this video, we will be demonstrating the friction and incline plane kit, the ES8, which is an experiment within the engineering science range of teaching apparatus from TecQuipment. The purpose of this experiment is to demonstrate kinetic and static friction and also rolling friction on bodies. In addition, you can study these with extra variables such as different surfaces and on either a flat or inclined plane. There are options with this to run various different experiments to introduce students to important engineering and scientific terms such as the coefficient of friction, sliding friction and kinetic friction. Let's take a look around the experiment. The parts of the experiment mount onto the separately supplied engineering science work panel known as the ES1. Engineers usually try to reduce friction because it wastes energy, absorbing power and causing wear. However, friction can also be useful, for example, in friction brakes, etc. Using these experiments, students can use a combination of planes with different surfaces, masses, a roller, and a sled to learn how different surface finishes and mass affect friction and how surface angles and mass affect forces around a body on a plane. There are four main areas of study: the inclined plane, friction, sliding friction, and rolling friction. The inclinable plane here allows students to do the classic forces on an inclined plane experiment. It also shows the relationship between frictional forces and angles other than horizontal. With the first experiment, you can set the incline at different angles, i.e. 15, 25, through to 55 degrees, and record variables such as the predicted normal reaction force, actual normal reaction weight and force, then the same for the parallel reactions. On to the experiment for understanding sliding and rolling friction. Using the sled, we add a metal friction plate under the sled, then add weights to the sled until it starts to move, recording the weight needed to move the sled. After that, you can try again without the metal friction plate. More variables can be added by resting the sled with a metal plate attached onto the roller, plus a rubber surface so you can compare with the friction level of this surface. For a better understanding of sliding friction, you can investigate the static and kinetic friction forces on different surfaces and determine the coefficient of friction. We get the plane level, put the metal friction plate under the sled, and find a mass of the sled by hanging it here so it balances. With the sled weighed, we put the sled on the level plane, we add pulling weights until the force overcomes the static friction and record the pulling weight. Then we add weights onto the sled and do this again, repeating with a wooden friction plate, wooden plane and plastic too. You record the results and draw a best fit line through the graph. This allows you to find the gradient of the results to find the average static coefficient of friction. Obviously, the user manual steps you through this process in much greater detail. I'm just giving you an idea for what it looked like. You can do a similar experiment to work out the kinetic coefficient of friction as well. Lastly, there is the angle of friction experiment that allows you to learn about the theory that predicts kinetic frictional forces from the angle of the plane. Here I've got it set up with metal on metal and I've put the sled on the far right. Now we slowly tilt the frame in 2.5 degree increments. We will see at what point the static friction breaks as the sled slides all the way down the plane. See? Like we did before, you can repeat with wood and the plastic so you can compare the results and draw your conclusions. For more information about the friction and incline plane kit and other kits and experiments in the engineering science range from TecQuipment, click on the links in the description box below. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and maybe consider following the TecQuipment YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.